anatomy and physiology for the GNM first years. And in this we are going to discuss about the unit 7, that is digestive system. So in the last class we have seen up to the esophagus, and now we are going to discuss about the stomach. So today topic is stomach, that is it is a J shape and it is present in the left side of the abdominal cavity. So stomach is become J shape and it can be situated at the left side of the abdominal cavity, and it is a muscular bag and forming the widest and most distensible part of the digestive tube. So it is a muscular bag, so it is a become bag and it is become widest and more distensible, means the stomach can be stretchable and it is a part of the digestive tube. So it is become widest and more stretchable if you are eating the food, and the stomach become distended. So if you are not eating, or if you are not eating, if you are not taking any food, the stomach become and the become contracted. So there is a widest and most distensible part of the digestive tube, and it is connected above to the esophagus. So the stomach is can be connected upside with the esophagus. So the lower part of the esophagus can be connected with the stomach and below to the duodenum. So the stomach can be, lower part of the stomach can be connected to the duodenum, upper part of the stomach can be connected to the esophagus, and it acts as a reservoir of the food and helps in the digestion of carbohydrates and the proteins and the fat. So there is a reservoir of the food. It acts as a stomach. It acts as a reservoir of food. So after taking the food can be digested into the stomach, and the stomach can be hold the food for the digestion. And because of this, it is called as a reservoir of the food, and it can be helps in the digestion of the carbohydrates and the fat and proteins. And it is the about the stomach. So the stomach, it is become J shaped. So the stomach, it consists of three parts. First one is the fundus. So the upper part of the stomach, it is called as fundus, and the middle part of the stomach, it is called as body, and there is a lower part of the stomach, it is called as pyloric antrum. So it is upper part of the stomach and the middle part of the stomach and the lower part of the stomach, it is called as pyloric antrum. So it is the anterior part of the anterior surface of the stomach. So backside, it is called as posterior surface of the stomach. So it is become anterior surface, and backside it is called as posterior surface of the stomach. So it is, there is a curvature, it is curvature, it is called as greater curvature, and there is a less curvature, it is called as less curvature. And the next one is the pyloric orifice. So the pyloric orifice, it can be connected, it can be, orifice means there is a opening. So the pyloric orifice can be situated at the junction of the stomach and the duodenum. So the after the digestion of the food into the stomach, and it can be enter into the duodenum by the pyloric orifice. So by this opening, the digested food can be enter into the duodenum. So the pyloric orifice means there is a opening, and it can be situated at the junction of the stomach and the duodenum. And the next one is the cardiac orifice. So the cardiac orifice, it is become the lower left chamber of the heart, and there is a orifice opening, and the can be the aorta can be connected to the stomach. So there is a cardiac orifice. So from this aorta, the blood supply to the stomach by the cardiac orifice. So it is about the two orifice, there is a cardiac orifice and the pyloric orifice. So the cardiac orifice can be located at the aorta, the left chamber of the heart, and it can be connects to the upper part of the stomach. So the blood supply to the stomach by the cardiac orifice, and there is a two curvatures, there is a greater curvature and the lesser curvature. So in the stomach three parts, it includes the upper part is fundus, and the middle part is body, and there is a lower part is pyloric and drum. So it is about the stomach. And the next one is the anteriorly. So what are the parts can be situated? And there is a anteriorly the left lobe of the liver. So the left lower of the liver can be situated at the anterior part of the stomach. And there is a posteriorly abdominal aorta and the pancreas and the spleen. So posterior part of the stomach, there is a abdominal aorta and the pancreas and the spleen can be situated. And the next one is superiorly. So superior part of the stomach, there is a diaphragm can be situated and the esophagus. So superiorly the stomach is connected with the esophagus, and the diaphragm also can be situated at the superior part of the stomach. And there is a inferiorly the colon and the small intestine. So inferiorly, inferior part of the stomach, inferiorly there is a colon and the small intestine can be situated. And at the left side the diaphragm and the spleen, and the right side of the stomach the liver and the duodenum can be situated. So the liver is the accessory muscles, and there is a situated at the side of the right side of the stomach. So there is a anteriorly left lobe of the liver, and posteriorly abdominal aorta and the pancreas and the spleen, superiorly the diaphragm and esophagus, and inferiorly the colon and the small intestine. So left side of the stomach the diaphragm and the spleen can be situated, and the right side of the stomach the liver and the duodenum can be situated. So next is the shape. So the stomach, if the stomach is become empty, it is become J shape. So if you are not taking, or if you are not taking any food and the stomach is become empty, it is become J shape. So when the stomach is become empty, it is become J shape, and the distended and the piriform shape. So when while taking the food, after taking the food, the stomach is become distended and it is become piriform shape. So piriform shape, it is nothing but P shape. So it is like B shape. So kidney shape. So it is become empty and it is become J shape. And if you are distended, if the stomach is distended and it is piriform shape. So piriform shape, it is not piriform shape, it is nothing but P shape or the B shape. And the next one is the length of the stomach. It is well distended and it is become 225 centimeters. So the length of the stomach is 25 centimeters. And the capacity, so the capacity of the stomach, there is a 1 ounce at the birth. So 1 ounce means there is a 29.5 at the 30 grams. So the capacity 1 ounce at the birth. So at the birth the capacity of the stomach is 1 ounce. 1 ounce means there is a 29.5 to 30 grams. And next one is the 1 liter at puberty. So at the level of the 12 to 13 years of age, the capacity of the stomach is 1 liter. And at the adult age, the capacity of the stomach is 1 liter to the 1.5 liter in the adults. So it is about the capacity 1 ounce at the birth and 1 liter at puberty, and 1 to 1.5 liter at the in age group of adults. And the next one is the structure of the stomach. So the structure of the stomach, it includes the 4 layers. So the 4 layers, it includes the outer serous layer and the muscular coat, and there is a submucosa layer and the inner mucosa layer. So the 4 layers can be involved in the formation of the stomach. So structure of the stomach includes the 4 layers. The first one is the outer serous layer. So it is formed by the peritoneum except at the curvature where the omenta is attached. So there is a outer serous layer. It is formed by the peritoneum. So peritoneum, it is outer layer of the stomach and except the curvature where the omenta is attached. So where the curvature is present and out of this the total stomach or the can be covered by the outer serous layer and except the omenta. So it is also one of the layer and it covers the internal organs of the stomach. So there is a internal parts of the stomach. So the outer serous layer, it can be covers the outer layer of the stomach and it covers the stomach. So next one is the muscular coat. So in the muscular coat, it includes the three layers, the outer layer and the middle layer and the inner layer. So outer layer of longitudinal fibers lie superiorly and superficially and continuous with the esophagus. So the outer layer can be situated superficially and it can be continuous with the esophagus. So it can be superficially covers the stomach and there is a middle layer of circular fibers are thickest at the pylorus. So there is a thickest, so the middle layer become thickest at the pylorus. So where the junction of the stomach and the duodenum and there is a pylorus can be situated. So the middle layer is become thickest at the pylorus and next one is the inner layer of oblique fibers which are found at the fundus of the stomach. So the fundus is upper part of the stomach and it can be covered by the inner layer of the oblique fibers. So in the muscular coat includes the three layers, the outer layer of the longitudinal fibers and the middle layer of circular fibers and the inner layer of oblique fibers. The next one is the submucosa layer. So the submucosa layer, it is formed areolar tissue and blood vessels and the lymph vessels. So the submucosa layer, it can be covers the areolar tissue and the blood vessels and the lymph vessels. So next one is the inner mucosa layer. So the gastric glands are situated in this layer and it consists of two orifices, that is called as cardiac orifice and the pylori orifice. So the cardiac orifice, it can be situated at the aorta to the stomach and the pylori orifice, it can be situated at the junction between the stomach and the duodenum and the two curvatures includes the greater curvature and the lesser curvature and the two surfaces, there is a anterior surface and the posterior surfaces. So there is a anterior part of the stomach called as anterior surface and the posterior part of stomach, it is called as posterior surface. So the inner mucosa layer, it consists of gastric glands and situated in this layer. So the gastric glands can be situated in the inner mucous layer and this inner mucosa layer, it covers the cardiac orifice and the pyloric orifice and the two curvatures and two surfaces can be covered by the inner mucosa layer. So these are all the four types of the layers, it can be involved in the formation of the structure of the stomach. So it is about the part 1 about the stomach.